So go through the preamble. Welcome to the Revenue Committee's public hearing. My name is Brad Von Gillen. I'm a senator from Legislative District 4 in Elkhorn in West Omaha. I represent District 4 again. I serve as the vice chair of this committee. I need to rewrite my own script. The committee will take up the bills in the order they're posted outside the hearing room. Our hearing today is your public part of the legislative process. This is your opportunity to express your position on the proposed legislation before us today. We do ask that you limit handouts. If you're unable to attend a public hearing and would like your position stated for the record, you may submit your position and any comments using the legislature's website by 12 p.m. the day prior to the hearing. Letters emailed to a senator or staff member will not be a part of the permanent record. If you're unable to attend and testify at a public hearing due to a disability, you may use the Nebraska Legislature's website to submit written testimony and live in-person testimony. To better facilitate today's proceeding, I ask that you follow these procedures. Please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices. The order of testimony will be the introducer, proponents, opponents, neutrals, and the closing remarks. If you'll be testifying, please complete the green form and hand it to the committee clerk when you come up to testify. If you have written materials that you'd like distributed to the committee, please hand them to the page to distribute. We need 11 copies for all committee members and staff. If you need additional copies, please ask a page to make copies for you now. When you begin to testify, please state and spell your name for the record. Please be concise. It's my request that you limit your testimony to 1 minute, and we will use a light system.
1 minute.
I agree. Three.
Seeing the bulk of testifiers, we'll go 3 minutes. Yellow will tell you you have 1 minute remaining. If your remarks were reflected in previous testimony or if you'd like your positions to be known but do not wish to testify, please sign the white form at the back of the room. It will be included in the official record. Please speak directly into the microphone so our transcribers are able to hear your testimony clearly. I'd like to introduce committee staff. To my immediate left is research analyst Charles Hamilton. To the far left is committee clerk Thomas Weekly. Committee members with us today will introduce themselves, beginning at my far right.
Kathleen Kapp, LD 31.
Dave Merman, District 38.
Elliot Bostar, District 29.
And Joni Albright, District 17.
Thank you. And if our pages would stand, and we want to give thanks to you for serving us well. Landon, who's a senior at UNL in political science, and Caitlin, who's been faithfully with us the whole hearing season, who's a junior at UNL in political science. Thank you. Where's Amelia today? All right. Please remember that senators may come and go during our hearing as they may have bills to introduce into the committees. Refrain from applause. Well, we just blew that one. Or other indications of support or opposition. For our audience, microphones are not for amplification, but for recording purposes only. Lastly, we use electronic devices to distribute information. Therefore, you may see committee members referencing information on their electronic devices. Be assured that your presence here today and your testimony are important to us and are a critical part of our state government. And with that, we will open, and we're going to do three bills together. We'll open on LB 694, 387, and 388. And welcome, Senator Linehan.
Thank you, Vice Chair Von Gillen and members of the Revenue Committee. I am Lou Ann Linehan, L-O-U-A-N-N-L-I-N-E-H-A-N. And I am from Legislative District 39, which is Elkhorn and Waterloo in Douglas County, Nebraska. Today, I'm here to introduce LB 369, LB 387, and LB 388. LB 369, 387, and 388 are vehicles for use to package tax legislation later in the session. These bills can be considered at a later date by the committee for advancement to the floor. So these are normally called shell bills. So if we go through the session and we get to the end and we have to make adjustments, two of these bills have been prioritized by the speaker. So we will have a package that we can use, which is what we didn't have last year. My Senator Friesen got to own the bill. With that, I'll answer any questions.
Any questions from the committee? Seeing none, will you stay to close?
Certainly. Thank you.
We'd like to welcome up proponent testimony. Yeah, I knew I was going to get you on that one. Seeing no proponents, we will welcome up opponent testimony. Welcome.
G-
Good afternoon, Vice Chair Von Gillern and members of the Revenue Committee. For the last time this year, I'm Joey Adler-Ruane, J-O-E-Y-A-D-L-E-R-R-U-A-N-E, and I'm the Policy Director at Open Sky Policy Institute, here to testify in opposition to 387 and 388, because we're concerned any potential changes made may increase the regressivity of Nebraska's tax code. Nebraska already has an overall regressive tax code. That means low and middle income families in the state pay a greater portion of their income taxes than higher income Nebraskans. Income taxes are the one tax in Nebraska that are progressive. As the marginal rate increases, as one's income increases, and we offer credits for low income Nebraskans like the earned income tax credit. However, legislation enacted last year and the legislation being debated this year will reduce the progressivity of the income tax code by flattening out this graduated rate structure. Graduated rates ensure income taxes increases the ability to pay increases. They also ensure a fair and sustainable revenue stream for the state, and we support maintaining it or even graduating it further. When states have flat or more aggressive income tax structures, they tend to rely more heavily on sales and consumption taxes, which fall harder on the lowest paid workers who pay a greater share of their income in those taxes than income taxes. Thanks for your time. Happy to answer any questions.
Thank you for your testimony. Any questions from the committee? Seeing none.
Have a good weekend.
Thank you for your testimony, Mr. Adler-Ruane. Any other opponent testimony? Seeing none. Anyone like to testify in the neutral position? Seeing none. Senator Linehan, would you like to close? Senator Linehan waves closing. We have one letter in opposition to LB 369. No proponents and no neutral testifiers. So